According to Mosby's Dictionary of Medicine, cardiovascular disease is any abnormal condition characterized by dysfunction of the heart and blood vessels.
Hi, my name is Krista. Your classmates, Amber, Brittany, Chanel, and D'Amica want to tell you about some nursing interventions for cardiac patients. You can encourage low-sodium meals. This helps keep sodium intake under control, which contributes to swelling. Recommend weighing the patient daily, especially a patient with congestive heart failure. This shows if edema is occurring. Also, omega-3 fatty acids will help keep blood pressures low. Schedule a meeting with a nutritionist to give the patient an opportunity to learn what foods are a healthy choice and to learn recommended values of nutrients from food. Establishing a healthy eating plan and diet modifications will allow the patient to adjust to healthy eating habits without eliminating all accustomed foods at once. Now, sit back and enjoy the rest of the presentation.
There are several risk factors that can contribute to cardiovascular disease, such as age, gender, family history, smoking, high blood pressure, high cholesterol, obesity, as well as diabetes. Now, here is a word from one of our heart-healthy friends.
Hi, I'm Dr. Mehmet Oz. February is Heart Month, and here at New York Presbyterian, we are teaming up to help you live heart-healthy. How are you going to do that? We're going to make you the world expert on your body. First off, you got to exercise. Listen, I have traveled all over the planet looking at places where people live a long time, and guess what? They share one common attribute: daily vigorous physical activity. So go out and get your exercise. I recommend 30 minutes a day. Get your heart rate up a little bit. Walk a little faster, not just stroll in the park. But if you get your heart rate up and rev those engines, you'll live longer and live better.
Thank you.